woods must a man walk down.
Yitzhak Navon was elected as the fifth president of Israel and has in fact spent the better part of his life as a public servant. Where does he see the changes in the political world over the years?
I think there was more accent on ideology in the past than at present. In the past, you join a party mainly because of its ideology, its program. But today you see people moving from one party to another without much ado. The main motive, unfortunately, is not the ideological part, but rather the personal conquest of seats and places.
Navon started his career serving as political secretary of Israel's first prime minister, David Ben-Gurion. Someone of this stature can be hard to replace.
What I miss in the political life of our days is a man like Ben-Gurion. There was no one equal to him. Ben-Gurion was the prime minister, a minister of defense. One day he received a book, four volumes, The Life and Philosophy of Spinoza, written in Spanish. He decided to study Spanish in order to read the books. And he asked, could you find someone who would teach me Spanish? So they told me, here is Navon, who have just come from Argentina and Uruguay. Maybe he can teach you. And so we started. He influenced my point of view, my view of our problems, more than any other thing.
Navon's greatest challenge may have been helping build the new ties between Israel and its now peaceful neighbor, Egypt.
When I received an official invitation by President Sadat, I went to Egypt on an official visit. President Sadat opened all channels of communication, television, press, I think, for me, and luckily, being able to speak in Arabic, I could communicate easily with people. Sadat said, you came, you conquered the hearts of the Egyptian people. You strengthened the peace between us. Maybe that was one of the most moving experiences that I had as a president.
When greeting Jews visiting from abroad, Navon has some clear messages.
There are so many delegations and people that come, Jews that come from abroad and would like to meet the president and hear from him messages. I used to explain my point of view. I wish they could give more emphasis on Jewish education. Secondly, avoid as far as possible mixed marriages and have a large number of children. Some may consider that as a motive for having more children. I could have only two, but not because I didn't want to.
After a long period of time as president, Navon was moved to re-enter the political arena.
The first war of Lebanon was a grievous mistake. I thought it was an irresponsible thing, and I wanted to contribute to change the government. I went back to the politics, and I made a mistake. Because when you are president, you get the sympathy of all walks of life, all political parties, you take all that sympathy and bring it, give it to a certain party. I would advise a president, anyone who goes to the presidency, when he's off, that's it. Should go to university, academy, or any other thing, not to politics.